I don't think that they were that way from the
baseball in a highly unorthodox fashion. And the rest, as they say, is history. He would be shortly after discovered by the Boston Braves, who would become the Milwaukee Braves, who, of course, would become the Atlanta Braves. And Mr. Aaron will go down in this sport as one of his all-time greatest players. But it all began in the Negro Leagues in 1952.
The batter, number 8.
His hands look upside down when he batted. His hands upside down.
Here comes young Henry Aaron to the plate.
Everyone thinks of Henry Aaron with that number 44 on his back, but his first number with the Braves was actually number 5. He didn't get 44 until his second season.
Bates stands at third with one gone in the inning. Swings through that. Chris, on that number change for Aaron, he asked for a repeating number, so he got 44. He hit exactly 44 homers in 4 different seasons. The guy who gave him the number joke, he should have assigned Hank number 66. Hacks and misses. It's a strikeout. On the ground to short. Now he steps out of the box as he asks for time.
The Clowns were so proud of being Aaron's first professional team, they advertised that he'd started his career with them until years after he'd retired from MLB.
Oh, shit, I had it.
And now the lefty. Swing and a miss, and he was fooled.
Oh, shoot, it's a count.
Like this.
Hard hit, left side. One gone, bottom of the third inning. Swing and a miss. It's 0-1.
0-1.
This one in the air. West under it. And makes the grab. And that is that.
God damn. They don't keep up time to match that.
On its way to the corner, Sellers on the move towards the line. Couldn't get to it before it dropped foul. Man at second. That one is hammered right field back there. And it's off the wall. They extend their lead as the runner scores from second. It's 6-3.
For a young Henry Aaron to leave Mobile to go join the Indianapolis Clowns, I think he had the fastest hands through the hitting zone this sport has ever seen.
Hank Aaron finds one he likes and singles into right field.
As he himself would say, I never looked for a fastball because I didn't think anyone could get one by me. And he was only hitting about 467 when he was signed away to go join then the Boston Braves. Oh, yeah, the hammer was destined to be one of, and in the eyes from this kid from Crawfordville, Georgia, the greatest baseball player of all time.
Seriously announced that he was going to challenge the great Bambino. Has done it here tonight.
What?
Derek Jeter comes to the plate with a chance to get.
So two down. Henry Aaron digging in now. On the ground to third, into the outfield, base hit. Joey gets on base and keeps it going.
Henry Aaron had such a pure hitting approach, Lou. If you took out his 755 career homers, he'd still have more than 3,000 career hits. Just amazing. Guy batted over 314 of his 23 MLB seasons.
That one gets down for a hit. You know, Singy, it's not just the win column that's so impressive for the New York Yankees. This offense, the speed, the power, and maybe nobody demonstrates that more than Derek Jeter as he steps to the plate once again. In steps the hard swinging youngster Henry Aaron.
They just start making it difficult, man.
In 1948, Henry Aaron got to see Jackie Robinson speak in Henry's hometown of Mobile, Alabama. Henry told his dad he'd reached the majors before Jackie retired, and he was right. Aaron debuted in 1954, and Jackie retired a couple of years later.
The shortstop takes the ball. Chris, that story you told about Aaron and Jackie is great. And it's a good reminder that Henry had more than just power in his game. He stole 240 bases in the majors, including 28 when he was 34 years old. Swing and a base hit. And that keeps the inning going.
After Aaron signed with the Clowns, their manager, Bunny Downs, wrote to a friend that he thought Henry would develop into a great player one of these days. Safe to say that he nailed that scouting report.
In the dirt, blocked. Well done behind the dish. Another scouting report on Henry came from his first manager with the Braves, Charlie Grimm, who said Henry's strike zone was, quote, a general area ranging from the top of his head to his toes, end quote. Remind you of anyone?
Oh, automatically Vlad Guerrero Sr. for sure.
Nabs it, out number two. And now the shortstop, Henry Aaron.
Mistake right here could untie this ball game. If you're the pitcher out there, you just want to be a little more cautious.
Bounce to the left side, and it goes just foul. And that is cut on and missed. One and two. Here's a high fly ball out to center. Newman moving under this one. And puts the squeeze on that one. And that is that. Here's the shortstop at the plate, Henry Aaron. Swings and misses. Slider right there. Right-hander kicks, deals, and fouled off.
With two strikes, may see some movement over there at first base, trying to stay out of the double play right here.
The 0-2 now. In the dirt. Henry Aaron digging in now. Missed inside with the curve. Swing and a miss. Nice changeup.
One and one.
Hard grounder into the outfield for a knock. And that one fouled off. Two on, one out. This one chopped in the ground, but foul.
One ball.
That skips in the dirt. Swings, threw it in. That's a strikeout. Pitch. We chase that time.
Count 1-0.
Fouled off down the right side. The pitch. Tapped at the plate, but it's a foul ball. And a 1-2. Battling here as he fouls it away. Nope. That one just misses. Bounced up the middle. Perry. Now the throw to first on the run. Leadoff man retired in the sixth. So digging in, Henry Aaron. On the ground to third. Tosses across to first. That ends the frame. So up next, Henry Aaron. Swing and a miss. Chased it out of the zone.
0-1.
And a pitch. And a ground ball to first. Oh, great stop. And very nicely done for the out. And now, Henry Aaron. Two outs. Swing and a miss as he chases that one darting out of the zone. Out to short, and it finds its way through for a hit. So a two-out knock keeps the inning alive, and he'll pull into second with two gone. Swing and a foul straight back. Righty delivers. And he chases that one below the zone. Oh, Blass stands at first with one out. In the air, out towards left center, and it drops in. Throw cut off to second, but he's in there easily.
By now, Jackie Robinson had broken baseball's color barrier. The major leagues were no longer a pipe dream. This was very real. But Henry Aaron already knew he had the confidence because what he knew is, if I can play in the Negro Leagues, I can play in any league. That's how great the talent was in the Negro Leagues. And for those Negro League players and his Indianapolis Clown teammates, they were never bitter. They may have lamented the fact that this happened when they were beyond their prime, but what did they do? They protected that young ball player as much as they could. They tried to shield them from as much of the harshness that life on the road in the Negro Leagues presented, because they knew that a young Henry Aaron had an opportunity. And Henry Aaron and Ernie Banks and the other young stars that left the Negro Leagues, they never forgot that. They carried that spirit with them as they continued to make their journey and transition into Major League Baseball.
Henry Aaron digging in now. And the pitch. West lost the second. Wide throw, and it gets away. Bennett back to work. Now fly ball to right center. Sellers on his way over. He's got it. One away.
You know, we've talked before about Henry Aaron's consistent excellence, but one stat that really stands out is his single season high for homers. Only 47, but he hit 30 or more homers in 15 seasons, just like clockwork.
Kicks and fires. Swings and misses. 0-2. What you were saying about Aaron's consistency, Chris, it doesn't happen without staying on the field. He played at least 145 games in 16 seasons, and that's tied for second all time. Play is made, two out.
That durability of Aaron's has a lot to do with his athleticism. Warren Spahn said he'd be the perfect ball player to clone, and that he thought Henry could have been a 20-game winner on the mound.
Two down, nobody on. Late on that fastball. Backed off the plate that time. On the ground, right side. Slings to first. That ends the inning. And now it's going to be Henry Aaron. And a pitch. The shortstop takes the ball. And he deals. And that's outside. And the count 2-1.
Yeah,
That one missed. Sliced hard, but foul. And here it comes. Foul. We'll see another payoff pitch. Some heat there at 98 miles an hour. That one to first, and foul ball. Two on, one out. Swing and a miss as he was late that time. Got him swinging. To kick the pitch. And there's a ball.
Ball one, no strike.
And it's fouled away.
See, that's what I was taught to do. I probably learned more from Coach Gwynn than I did from the
swing and a miss. One and two.
One ball, two strikes.
That one almost got him. The pitch. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. Chase the fastball up the ladder for strike three. Now it's the shortstop, Henry Aaron. And that one is lifted in the air. Sellers on the run towards the line. Tracks it down for the out. And that is that.
But it's so remarkable.